Hello, and welcome to Homespun Handcrafts Brown Bag Bookbinding. First, I'm going to go over the materials you need. So you're going to need some sort of brown paper bag, embroidery floss, an embroidery needle, some watercolors to decorate, some water, 5 pieces of just plain white paper. This is a template that is going to be in your kit. It's just a piece of paper with holes spaced evenly across the middle of it. And you're going to need a scissor as well. So the first thing we're going to do is take our brown bag and we're going to cut it along the seams where the bottom folds in. So I'm going to cut this seam here. And then do the same on this side. And then open up the bottom seams as well. Okay. And now when you lay it flat, it gives you this nice big area on the inside here that we're going to use to cut out our bag. I'm just going to trim this bit on the bottom off as well because we're not going to use this part. Okay, so now that that's ready, next thing we're going to do is get our paper ready. So I just have it in one big stack here and we are going to fold it in half. Right down the middle. You're gonna wanna take a second to make sure all your edges line up, just so that it's an even. So your paper isn't crooked. Okay. Fold it right down the middle. And then you're going to take your scissor and cut along that center crease. Okay. Now you have your pages ready like that. So you're going to lay it on top of your brown bag. And you're going to cut your bag out to the same shape as the paper. Now, as you can see, it all lines up. Now you're going to take this and fold it in half. And once you do this, you're going to decide which side you want to be the top, the front, and which side you want to be the back. And then when you open it up, you have the crease down the center. And you're going to place the piece of paper with the dots on it over the top. And now you're going to take your, let me clean that up. You're going to take your embroidery needle and you're going to poke through where each of the holes is. And it's a little tricky to poke through far enough, so just keep at it and you'll get there. Last one. Now you're going to take some embroidery floss. And you want it to be about double the length, a little over double the length of your book. And then trim it off. You're going to tie a knot onto one end of it. Okay, there we go. And then you're going to thread your embroidery needle. So you're going to start with your center hole. Get all these lined up properly. And you're going to go from the inside to the outside. And then you're going to go to the second hole. You're going to go from the outside to the inside. Okay. just tug the embroidery floss tight. Now we're going to the third hole. We're going from the inside to the outside. Once again, pull it tight. And then we go back to the second hole. And we're going from the outside to the inside. And pull it tight again. And then back to the first hole. From the inside to the outside. And then my third hole was a little bit off center, so I'm just gonna move it in a little bit. Pull it tight again, and then you're going to go to the fourth hole. And then back to the third hole. Oops. My needle got unthreaded there. Inside. And back to the center. You're just going to go a little bit over to the side of the center. And poke a second hole. Okay, pull that through. And now you're going to take your two ends. Tie a knot. and then you can trim the ends off. And then when you fold it in half, it's a little hook, it stays together. And you can go across and trim the edges so that everything lines up. Up your little book, and now it's time to decorate it. So for the watercolors, you can use your piece of paper that had the dots on it to test colors. And then you can paint whatever design you want onto here. I'm going to do some chevrons and purple. You could also do flowers, you can do dots, whatever you like. And as you can see, I messed the pattern up a little bit here, so that's going to be the back side. this gap here is a little bit bigger, so I'm going to go back in and fix it. Alright, I'll wipe that down properly in a minute. One more down on the bottom. And it will take a minute for the watercolors to fully dry, but there you have it. A little book made out of brown bags and just some office paper. And you can use this for notes, whatever you want.